Jesus your choice. If you're here this morning, you need to be a member of the church of the firstborn. Jesus Christ is the firstborn. So that means being a member of the church of Christ. The Bible informs us that just like in our world, back during the days of the apostles, yeah, there was some misunderstanding as to who Jesus was. Jesus took his apostles down to the coast of Caesarea Philippi, asked them in a conversation between just them and him, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? Some said he was John the Baptist. Some said he was Elijah. Some said he was Jeremiah or one of the prophets. But then that's when Jesus turned the question to his own apostles and said, but whom do ye say that I, the Son of Man, am? That's when Peter said that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus said, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, because flesh and blood has not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. What he's saying, Jesus, didn't no man tell you, Peter, what you just said about me? There was no way that Peter could have known that he was the Christ, the Son of the living God, except God had revealed it unto him. Yes. See, the mystery that had been hid in God was that God was going to send his Son down to this old earth. He was going to send him from judgment hall to judgment hall. He was going to send him from chief ruler to ruler. He was going to send him before king and governor alike, and that they were going to determine that he ought to be put to death by crucifixion. God had decided that they were to hang him high and stretch him wide. God had decided that they were to put nails in his hands and nails in his feet. God had decided that he was going to allow men who were created in his image to stand there at the foot of the cross and mock and scorn him. They said he called for Elijah. Let's see if Elijah will come. They heard him call on God. They say that he had helped and saved others, but himself he cannot save. Let us see what's going to happen to him. And so God had determined that men who were created in his image would mock and scorn him. They would laugh him to shame. And that in his humiliation and shame, he's going to die for the sins of the world. God had determined that a soldier would take a spear and pierce him in his sweet side. God had determined that out of his side would come blood and water. And it's that same blood that God had determined that would be the cleansing agent for you and for me, so that we could be a part of that one body, which is the body of Christ. That's the reason Jesus said that he is the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come unto the Father unless they come through him. They've got to get into the body in order to get to God. They've got to be in Christ in order to spend eternity with God in heaven. And the only way that God has determined or ordained for a man to get in Christ is to be baptized into Christ. That's the reason Jesus said in Mark chapter 16 and beginning at verse number 15, when he sent his apostles forth and told them to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature, he says, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, and he that believeth not shall be damned. Oh, Jesus fixed it because it was always a part of God's plan for man to believe in him as the Son of God. It was always a part of God's plan for that man to repent of his sins. It was always a part of God's plan for the man to make that confession with his mouth that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. It was always a part of God's plan to have that man baptized in water. And when he went down into the water, he was going to come in contact with the blood. That's the reason that scene is given unto us in John 19. That when that soldier took that spear and pierced his side, out of his side came blood and water. There's blood in the water because God said, in order to be saved, we got to go down into the water. And the blood is the saving agent that removes our sins. It removes our transgressions. It removes our faults and cleanses us and puts us in a position with God where we'll be covered in the blood, so that when Jesus comes back, he's looking for all the folk who are covered in the blood. He's looking for people who have become a part of his body. He's looking for people who have been baptized for the remission of their sins. God has added them to the church, and they're going to be where they need to be, because the church was according to the eternal purpose of God. It is against God's purpose for us to be divided into different religious bodies when Jesus prayed that we might all be one as him and the Father is one. So the eternal purpose of God is fulfilled in the church. God had a plan. And in this plan, God had purposed and determined all of his children were going to be in one body. God decided that.
Amen.
Church of Christ didn't come up and decide that.
That's right.
God decided that. And when you're talking to people about the Lord's church, help them to understand we are not a denomination. We're not just a church among churches. And that's what this series is for. The eternal purpose of God is to help you to understand that the church of Christ is according to the eternal purpose of God.
Amen.
This ain't something that just sprung up so we can combat other folk. God decided long before he brought the monkey into existence, he was going to have a church. And all of his folk, we're going to be in that church. God decided that.
Yes.
And God decided that. That's the way it's going to be.
Amen.
It don't matter that you don't like it. That's the way it's going to be. It don't matter that that's not the way you want it. Come the day of judgment, I'm hoping you change before then.
Yeah.
But come the day of judgment, you will witness those who will be rising up, those who will still be down.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. In the day of judgment, you will see Jesus deliver up the kingdom according to 1 Corinthians 15. He will deliver up the kingdom to God. The church and the kingdom are one and the same.
Still talking about the